yellow, I see green. They are magnificent. But they also remind me that I can continue to fall for Jesus, just like fall in autumn. I can fall for Jesus and fall right into his arms. The other thing is that I know that Jesus says that he will never leave me nor forsake me in his words. I cannot wait to hear more about that.
Daniel, one of the Jewish exiles in Babylon, served the rulers of Babylon his whole life. When Darius became king, he put Daniel and two other high officials in charge of all the workers who collected money for the king's treasury. Daniel did such a good job and served with such a great spirit that Darius planned to put him in charge of the whole kingdom. That made the other high officials jealous. They wanted to find a reason to get rid of Daniel, so they watched him carefully, but he never did anything wrong. Now the officials knew that Daniel loved God and prayed to God in his house 3 times every day. So they came up with a plan and presented it to the king. "Oh, king, we have a good idea," they said. "Make a law that no one in the kingdom may pray to anyone but you for 30 days. And if anyone pray to someone else, he will be thrown into the den of hungry lions." The king was Daniel's friend, and he should have realized his new law would hurt Daniel. But the king thought, "Yes, I would like everyone in the kingdom to pray only to me for 30 days. So he made a law and he signed it and sealed it with a special ring. Daniel heard about the new law, but he didn't stop praying to God, because praying to God was the right thing to do. He went to his house and knelt by the window and prayed to God 3 times every day, just as he had done before. The other officials spied on Daniel and saw what he was doing, and they hurried to tell the king. King Darius was very worried and upset. "What have I done?" he said. "There must be a way I can help Daniel instead of throwing him into the den of hungry lions." But even the king could not change a law once it was written. With great sadness, the king sent for Daniel. "May your God, whom you will serve, deliver you," the king said. Then the king's servant threw Daniel into the den of hungry lions. The king went back to the palace, but he could not eat or sleep. In the morning, at first light, he hurried back to the lion's den. "Daniel, servant of the living God, has your God saved you?" Would Daniel answer him? Would he hear Daniel's voice? "Yes." "Oh, king," Daniel answered, "God sent an angel to close the lions' mouths, and they have not hurt me." "Wonderful, wonderful," said the king. He ordered his servants to pull Daniel out of the lion's den right away. Then the king made a new law. Everyone in the kingdom must honor Daniel's God, for he is the living God, and he has saved Daniel from the power of the lions. Wow, that was an incredible story about Daniel in the lion's den.
Yes, it was.
That is so powerful. I could not even imagine. When I go to the zoo and see the lions, I cannot imagine something so powerful that can just like close a mouth of a hungry lion. You're not talking about like one that's like full and just had dinner and like is ready for a nap. You're talking about a lion that is so hungry and is dying to eat. Like he just wants to eat. He's just ready to eat.
Yes, they are so big and powerful too that a person like us, a mere man, would not have a chance.
No, we wouldn't. But God was, he closed the mouth. That's what scripture said. He just closed the lion's mouth. And they lay there peacefully until the next day when King Darius came and was like, "Oh my goodness, I pray that my friend Daniel's God saved him." And guess what? He did.
Because Daniel fell for Jesus and God. He loved him so much and he devoted his life towards him. And God said he would never leave him nor forsake him. And guess what? He didn't, did he?
No, he's always there.
He was right there. Even in the pit with the hungry lions, God was right there. And in our own lives, you know, when we're feeling like we're faced against these hungry lions that are just ready to devour us, mm-hmm. that God is right there. He's never going to leave us. And he has a plan for everything we go through, even whether it's good or bad. Just like he had a plan for Daniel to go through that bad situation, face a fear of being in a den with hungry lions. But God made something good come out of it. And what happened out of it? That the whole kingdom had to worship Daniel's God, our God, the one true God.
Yes, God is faithful. God loves us. And he'll always be there no matter what happens when we are going through a trial.
That's right. Oh, such a great reminder that we don't have to do this alone and we're never alone because he's right there with us.
Yes, he's always by our side.
So boys and girls, thank you so much for joining us this week. We hope you got a lot out of the story of Daniel and the lions. And when you look outside and you see those beautiful leaves of all different colors, I want you to think and remember that God will never leave you nor forsake you.
Yes, exactly.
So boys and girls, we love you. Jesus loves you. And we will see you next week.
Can't wait. Bye.